Hey y'all, we're here for a super impromptu GoPro vlog because I just did some amazing shit that I never thought I'd be able to do here in the little town of Iron Ridge. Yeah, I just chased this dude around in his sweet ass Can-Am ATV extreme off-road vehicle. I don't know what the hell you even call it, but the thing is way faster than my drone. And then I had the brilliant idea of trying to fly my drone while inside of the thing, and it lasted about 3 seconds because he took off so fast and hard that I couldn't even remotely control the drone. I could barely hold the radio. Yeah, it was insane. He took off so fast and hard that like, I couldn't hold my head straight. I couldn't hold the radio straight. I could not, I could not even remotely have any sorts of barrier of where I was or where the drone was. And I just, all I know is the drone went up. I have footage of it, so I don't even know what happened. The drone went up high, and I could not control it at all. I could not be freaked out because I was literally screaming the whole time because, A, I'd never been in the thing because it was so goddamn fast. Or, I've never been in the thing. And he took me for a ride after I tried doing that shit flying with the goggles on, and and I was scared shitless when I could see what was happening with my eyeballs. I was way more scared shitless with the goggles on. That was a stupid idea, a stupid, stupid idea. But thank God for his friend, Steve-O. Yeah, he saved the day. He knew right where that drone went down. Because I eventually ended up heading towards the trees, and I was just way too freaked out to even, I just disarmed. I just straight up panic disarmed because I was panicking.
Crash through.
Where'd it go?
It came right through here. It zipped right through here. So it's in them weeds somewhere, probably.
And I'm a dumbass. I should have brought the GoPro with me when he took me for a ride. Oh my God. My adrenaline is through the fucking roof right now. That was, man, that thing is fast and intense. And I can't believe if I just would have told him to relax and not go crazy with me flying, I might have been able to handle it. But holy shit, he took off like a briefed ape and it was all over almost immediately. Oh, but his friend saved the day big time by knowing right where that drone went down. He was literally standing in front of it. I mean, I didn't know he had that. I started looking all over the place like a dumbass, but he was literally standing right in front of it, and he saved the day twice. He saved the day by knowing right where it went in, and as I was walking back over to him, he picked up my transmitter and goggles to get it off the ground because Doug, God, I hope that's his name, Doug was gonna go around on the other side of the fence and look, and when he picked up my radio, he must have bumped the arm switch, and it started spinning the propellers, obviously, and I heard it. Whammy, thank you, you just saved the day. And it's still recording, even better. Wow. That was a dumb idea. And I was like, oh, there it is. And then I was like, here, give me that radio. And he gave me the radio and I disarmed it, picked it up, and voila. And this would all be on footage because it was still recording when I picked it up. Doug, Steve-O, that was fucking awesome. Hopefully we have more adventures like this. This one was too short. And I can't wait to chase some of your motocross buddies. Goddamn. That shit was awesome. Thanks again. See you later. Bye.